Hello everybody, welcome to Weathercast. So this is the new feature that I had started last week, which I call Start Your Week with Weather Updates. The basic idea is to give some general updates about monsoon rains over your region. So if you had observed my last update, which I posted on Sunday, last Sunday, which was July 12th, you must have seen that I had given what are the regions where heavy rainfall is expected, and I had mentioned that West Coast will get some heavy rainfall, especially North Konkan, and that's what happened. So similarly, today I will just give an overall general weather pattern that is expected over Indian region. These are unofficial updates, so I request you to follow IMD for the official updates. So as always, let me start with the synopsis and then get into the dynamics. So the monsoon axis, which was active over the central and west coast of India, is going to shift north. So what this means is that the north and northeast India will get some moderate to heavy rains. And this is the time for Delhi and the NCR region to score well. So those places have not been getting good rains and they are in deficit. But I think this week will be crucial as Delhi and NCR region is expected to get some good rains. And a cyclonic circulation is supposed to develop over central and east India around July 24th. And that will bring some good rains to central India and east India. And of course, these rains will be good for the farming community, especially the Vidarbha, Marathwada and the Telangana region. Those places, I think from July 24th onwards, they will get some heavy rains. Until then, some scattered light to moderate shower is possible, but the activity will pick up from 24th of June for Central India. West Coast is going to go on a mini break because as the axis shifts north, West Coast generally, the offshore trough weakens and that will result in a slightly reduced rainfall activity. But since the Arabian Sea is little active, on and off moderate rains are expected, but there is no issue of waterlogging or flooding that is expected in general over the west coast. The catchment areas near the west coast, especially the interior Maharashtra, which have not been getting good rains, the catchment areas are only 25% full, whereas last year they were almost 50% full by this time. So that is a concern. I think that the next 1 week is also going to be bad for the catchment areas. But starting from July 27th, we may expect the catchment areas to record some good rains. And August is especially crucial month where the catchment areas are expected to get some heavy rains, which may fulfill our water needs. And since there is a break phase in the west coast, the westerlies are weakening. So South India will get scattered thunderstorms. Places in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, South Karnataka will get some scattered thunderstorms. And since thunderstorms are localized event, they could be very heavy in one place and moderate in some other place. So expect some high intense thunderstorms in some places in South India. Okay, before I get into the dynamics, there is a wonder in the sky, which we call the comet Neowise. So the mini break phase over the west coast will allow one to witness the comet Neowise in the evenings. It is in the news that this comet is visible in India from July 14th onwards, and it will be visible up until August 2nd. On July 22nd, it will be closest to the Earth. So on that particular day, it will be visible very clearly. So since then over the west coast, the last week was very cloudy and it was raining almost the entire week. So this mini break phase will allow the people on the west coast, especially around Mumbai, Goa and coastal Karnataka and Kerala region, to witness this comet in the evening. So just look up in the evening when the sky is partially clear. And you may spot this comet, which is a very rare event. So that is one of the benefits of monsoon taking a break. Okay, so now getting to the dynamics. Before that, this is the overall performance. Many places are experiencing green is basically normal rainfall, blue is excess. So overall, we are in a departure. The departure is 10%. So overall, the performance for Pan India is positive, but some places are experiencing deficit rains, especially Kerala, which was unexpected. I was expecting Kerala to have been in green, but it will pick up because the season is not even half done. So I'm sure that Kerala will witness some good rains. North India has been in deficit, but this week, since the monsoon axis is shifting north, these places will of course cut into that deficit. Right? All other places are kind of doing okay. Alright, so the monsoon intra-season oscillation is shifting north, and that's the reason why you can see it's weak, but it is moving towards the North India and foothills. After that, it is going to again come into Central India, which is around August 1st week. So this week, since it is in a weak phase and over North Indian region, North India will perform, get some good rains is what I am expecting. So the trough will move to North India, and that is why places in Delhi and NCR will get some good rains, and also Northeast India will also get some heavy rains. So already twice this season North India has seen floods. So once again, these heavy rains may trigger landslides or flooding events in Northeast India. So vigilance has to be, they have to be vigilant, and I think prepared for such heavy rains and the aftermaths of such heavy rains. And like I said, around 24th, 25th, there will be a cyclonic circulation over Central India, and that will get deliver some heavy rains over the central parts, which will be good for the farming community. So that is what is happening. That is expected. And over the west coast, as you can see, there is a break phase, so only moderate rainfall is expected. South India, these rainfall numbers are very difficult to predict because the thunderstorms are very localized events, and hence, although it may show some moderate rains, but some places in South India may get some heavy rains because of the thunderstorms. Alright, so I hope this was useful. So basically, North India will get some good rains, West Coast will go on a break phase, South India will get some thunderstorms, and Central India and East Coast of India will get some rains from 24th onwards because of the cyclonic circulation that is developing over the land. So this is the general synopsis for next week. And of course, please, if you can witness the comet Neowise, which will be visible in the evening, and most of the west coast, since it will be a break phase, so the monsoon clouds will not hinder. So this is the best week to watch out for the comet Neowise for the west coast. Alright, so if you find my updates interesting and useful, please subscribe to my channel, where I'll present regular weather updates with the dynamics. Okay, and I'll be back next week with the similar weather updates for the following week. And until then, I'll sign off and say goodbye. Have a good week. Goodbye.